We're very excited to say that this video is sponsored by Nautilus. If you love learning and art just like Life Noggin does, stay tuned at the end of the video to hear more about the cool work done by Nautilus and how viewers of Life Noggin can save big.
This adorable video to...
Welcome to What's Gonna Kill Me, the game show where we ask our contestants, what's gonna kill you? Not to freak you out or anything, but the world is full of things that can kill you, from natural disasters to illnesses to wild animals. And I'm not talking about large predators like lions and crocodiles. Those only kill a couple of hundred to a thousand people a year. Those are rookie numbers. The world's deadliest creature is much, much smaller. Okay, guys, what's the world's deadliest creature? Any guesses? Anyone? Oh, so close, Triangle Bob. We were looking for mosquito, not a giant logo sign. Sorry. We'll talk more about the world's deadliest killers after a brief word from our intro. Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. Mosquitoes are responsible for the death of over 1 million people each year. But it's not the bite that kills them, it's the diseases they're carrying. These include viruses like dengue, West Nile, and Zika, as well as parasites like the one that causes malaria. In fact, malaria is responsible for the majority of mosquito-related deaths. The parasite infects blood cells, which can result in blood abnormalities or organ failure. And while preventative measures like insecticides and window screens have largely reduced the number of cases, malaria killed over 600,000 people just in 2020. But there's other diseases with an even higher death toll. In the past 200 years, tuberculosis has killed over 1 billion people, making it the deadliest infectious disease in history. Each year, it's responsible for the death of about 1.6 million people. It's by no means gone. Scientists believe that a third of the world's population are infected with a dormant form of this bacteria, but it can be reactivated and spread through coughing and sneezing. And those with a weakened immune system are most at risk. While it can be cured with antibiotics, there have also been drug-resistant tuberculosis cases documented all over the world, making treatment all the more complicated. But that's still not the world's deadliest killer. That award goes to an unavoidable process that all living things experience: aging. About 100,000 people die from age-related causes every day. That's because as you age, your body goes through lots of changes, like a decline in the function of organs or the immune system. Eventually, an organ fails or a disease is acquired, and that results in death. Fighting age-related diseases and aging in general is super important. We need to be putting a few more resources into treating that. For the top two deadliest diseases in the world, heart disease and cancer, aging is one of the most important risk factors. This is due to your arteries becoming harder and accumulating fatty deposits as you age, and your cells developing more and more genetic mutations over your lifetime. Hey, we all have to die of something. At least it won't be at the hands or the teeth of a lion. Oh, good, Triangle Bob is okay. Nope, spoke too soon. A lion has just attacked him. Whoops, sorry. So I wanted to try something in the comments. Ask me a question that you want to see as a Life Noggin video. The three questions that are the most liked will be added to our video list, pending the questions are appropriate. I reserve the right to, you know, not make them. But let's have some fun. Start commenting, start voting. Anyone who sees the value in using visuals or a unique idea to help people learn is a friend of Life Noggin. That's why I was, I guess you could say, overly excited when I got the chance to work with today's sponsor, Nautilus. If you're looking to shake up how you learn about the world beyond just YouTube, check this out. Nautilus explores big ideas in science. Its stories present ideas that will be debated long into the future, and as a result, has established itself as the foremost literary science magazine. You can join as a digital-only member, or print, to receive 6 beautifully illustrated award-winning collectible editions that are a staple of any respectable home library. One of my favorite parts is that in addition to full access to all the stories in Nautilus, members receive benefits like priority access to events, exclusive products, and product discounts. For example, Nautilus recently produced a line of ocean science-inspired merch with Australian streetwear company, Jungles. Quotes for the collection were provided by Roger Payne, the legendary biologist and environmentalist who discovered and first recorded humpback whale songs in 1967. All proceeds were donated to Nautilus's Ocean Conservation Fund. You see what I mean? It's this merger of art, culture, science, and discovery that make Nautilus stand apart from the traditional science news sources. Memberships to Nautilus rarely go on sale, but you can go to this link right here to receive 15% off your membership today. Use our code LIFENOGGIN to unlock the offer, or click the first link in the description and treat yourself to more fun ways to learn. Do all the things that help this channel grow, we really appreciate it. Click here to watch this video we did on overpopulation, or click here to watch this video. And if you want to support the people who are fighting age-related diseases every day, then you need to support lifespan.io. Check them out down in the description. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.